approach the podium for passport verification.
That thing sizzling.
Yeah, me right there, boy. Sao Paulo. La Puerta. 34.
Hey, met up with the bros. Hey!
What do? First thing, nigga, show up in Brazil. Had to get it, the Ciroc, 2 for $50.
They even put the number we need to call just in case we can't remember.
Yeah. Just in case.
Yeah. So this is the charger that we got out here in Brazil. The little outlet power thing.
Shit, man. Should all make sense. Charged up, baby. Charged.
Niggas ready to go.
Where that pull up at? You think when you get out of here, you're in Rio. You're fucking Rio.
I like that quote.
Here. We in there. Look, we got the little right downstairs, you know. We in the city though. We here.
We in the transit. Hey,
yo.
Say what up. Hey, that's the driver right there.
Hey, Eddie threw up the fight.
All the way up top, penthouse.
What was that? That's a dungeon.
We're gonna figure this shit out.
Yeah, eventually.
The rest of the troops done assembled. We got young. The rest of the troops done assembled. Y'all ain't see this shit. Y'all ain't see this lineup, did you?
You ain't see the lineup.
You didn't see this lineup.
Hey, you know.
Packages.
Whoa, hey, everybody made it. This shit gonna be a $2 split.
Shit.
Chest, and group home every day.
Oh, group home is my shit.
I listen to group home every
That's
day.
That's my shit.
Like, you don't want to cry after you sing it.
That was the brown paper bag, nigga.
If you don't want to cry after you sing it, then you ain't singing it right, bro.
You're not singing it right. Yes,
that was flying.
My shit, nigga. Yo, did they got the ox corn?
I
thought Sugarloaf was
Turn around. This way, y'all.
Oh, that's the Sugarloaf.
You have to take a cart up.
Let's go. Wait, this is my documentary. Look at the.
I'm ready.
Look at the Douglas Parker out of his natural element.
I'm out.
Fresh
I'm
from
out,
Nucio.
Yeah, yeah.
Fresh from Nucio. I mean, he's never
back.
Been
I'm
anywhere in his life before.
I've been more
he's
Nucio.
He's coming fresh out of these streets.
Have you been to South Africa?
He's an urban.
I've been to South Africa.
An urbanite.
Bro, what was that?
What was that?
I've been to South Africa.
Look at this.
That's your. I never did that before. Tell him what we're doing though.
Right now we're converting.
He said,
ocho y cinco reals to English dollars.
Spanish,
you hear me?
And
basically, she don't want to give us a discount though.
All right, come on. Why no discount though?
What you gonna play? What you gonna play? Please.
No, play at a low volume.
Not here. What's the popular song?
God's plan. Everybody heard God's plan.
Turn it on. Yeah, hold that.
Power. Yeah, up a little bit more. Yeah, up a little bit more.
I hear it.
I can tell you when I hear it up a little bit more. Right there.
Yes.
A little bit more. A little bit more.
I don't wanna die for them to miss me. Yes, I see the things that they wishing on me. Hope I got some brothers that outlive me.
I just want you to see this shit because we take this shit for granted. We laughing, we drinking, we having a good time, we snapping, we Instagramming, man. But really look at this shit.
That's a volcano.
But really look at this shit, man.
I'm looking.
We in motherfucking Rio, man. We are thousands and thousands of miles away, man. For real. We got failed on the plane over here and you ain't even know that shit.
Better story was different with me. God's plan.
Yo, Wakanda forever. Yeah, real life.
I finesse down Western Road, next. Might go down to G-O-D, wait. I go hard on Southside G, wait.
I mean, listen here.
Fuck it, we want the hat.
We all got it, man, we all can get here. The shit is open to us. They love us here.
They love us here.
Back to life real quick. My nigga Furo showed up. Hey, the Jewel here, nigga. Jewel here, nigga.
I'm Brazil. I'm Rio. Not the fuck, you know how it is.
Word, word, word.
It's a blue kind of day. That's why I got the blue Febreze.
Basically, man, we just walking, man. We just giving the people something new to look at, because we, as African Americans, man, we travel, but we don't travel in packs. We don't travel in numbers, man. So the more perspective they can get, the better. Travel, document that shit. Take pictures.
Yeah.
All right, cool. So, you know what I'm saying? Carlito done showed up. So now we're lining up. Nucio Cashville in the building. Yeah, yeah. Oh, shit, we got Miramar. We got Hollandale. We got St. Pete's Finest 727. Let them know what's going on. And we got Belize, Cayman, LA, Compton, nigga.
I know. I'm good, bro. I just came wrong with nothing.
They ain't tell us we was kings. We had to figure that out ourselves. So now that you know that, tell somebody else.
Where we going? Where we going right now?
We about to go see Christ. I'm about to ask him to forgive me for all my sins. You know what I'm saying?
I can picture a lot of y'all niggas popping this, bro.
This shit though.
Hey, hello. Hey. Huh? Over there. Guys, what's up? Come over.
Manda agora com ele, pro avisa, fica tudo mais ligado, fica agora ligeiro.
Hey.
Passando de lá.
For going back. You get as much love and you go back to all that hate.
Okay, cool.
Oh, shit.
Big shots.
Yo, drop that Kirk Franklin. We ain't never.
Serious. I'm about to
get
real serious.
Whoa.
Yeah, whoa.
Here he is, y'all.
Wow.
I'm feeling great, man.
Feeling good?
You know what I'm saying? In front of the Jesus the Redeemer, one of the nine wonders of the world, a definite bucket item list for me. You know what I'm saying? It's so huge. I didn't think it'd be this big in real life. Like, someone really came to Brazil, on the highest mountain in Brazil, to build the biggest Jesus in Brazil. And I'm looking at it right here. Like, we're literally in the clouds. Like, it's a hard time looking at Jesus because we're so high up. This is the 2018 equivalent of Mount Olympus, you understand? You know how people went to go see Zeus? We're in Rio de Janeiro on the highest mountain in South America looking at Jesus. This is Mount Olympus equivalent in 2018, baby.
We're ready, go ahead.
Diving day, it's early in the morning, it's like almost 5 a.m. We gotta go wake everybody up. Talking about like full gear, full equipment shit. That's what I've never even been close to anything like that. Wake everybody the fuck up. It's time to get everybody up.
Praying for the colonizers. Oh shit, that is cool.
I just wanna let y'all know.
That is cool.
All that, and we still ain't fuck with y'all.
That is.
Hey, I guess all.
Oh, we looked up who whatchamacallit was.
Harry Belafonte.
Harry Belafonte.
And you realized he was a real nigga.
Yeah,
right?
He was a real nigga. Yeah.
Admit that to
him. Oh my, did we discuss that? I'm sorry.
Harry Belafonte. Like, if Martin Luther King's like a 99 in Madden, he's like an 85.
Word. Boy, why you got shoes? Why you got extra shoes, nigga?
Chest
out right here. Oh, shit. Wow,
that shit crazy. I think you just down to let your apartment burn, right?
Something on fire, bro? What the fuck going on?
What
is
that, bro? How you wake up? How you wake up, nigga?
Like this, nigga.
Why, nigga?
My God, nigga. Nigga.
Hey, bro. Hey, bro. Hey, bro.
The fucking road. Where? Oh, man.
That's all you need, bro.
Oh my God. I got that on camera.
So we finally made it to the city where we're supposed to go scuba diving. We're really, really, really east. Really, we're probably like at the point right now. That's why you see all these dive shops. If you see that, it's a dive shop right there. There's like two more dive shops over there. Gonna have the shit in my eyes. Gonna hit the vein.
I was born in the darkness.
Party I wanted now. Nice game. No front, bro. I want a pair though, it's cool. That boy straight out of Jerusalem.
There it is.
That's it. Why that, bro?
That's it.
That was it, bro.
I don't really know how to scuba live like that, so I'm just gonna be the camera boy for the day. So all the stunning clips that y'all get today, just know it's because of me.
Start. You know how we do, bro. I'm the co-director of this bitch right now.
Hey, it's your boy, Live 5. You know, I didn't sleep.
Let's start hitting
him. That's what I'm doing every time. I didn't sleep much last night. I got like 30 minutes of sleep, but I'm still here. I'm going strong. Didn't have a good night last night, but I'm going to bounce back. You know what I'm saying? You already know what it is. 5-5 all day. Oh, Tony, the big fella.
What's up, Tony?
He's a little out of commission right now, but he'll be back. Give him an hour
or
so.
He'll be back.
I'm Chad everywhere he goes. You know what I'm saying? Chad, Chadito, Chado.
That never in life.
Something. But, yeah, man, just enjoying the spirits right now. We're on an island in the middle of fucking nowhere.
I'm letting these puppies out.
But the culture, the vibe is different, man. This is a different culture right here, man. So much to do, so much more to explore, so much things to get into. It's amazing the different cultures where you just like take it in and understand that, you know what? Outside of our bubble, there's more to life. Chin over here waiting for some sugar cane because we fucking island as fuck. That island shit carry around with us no matter where we go, baby. Island as fuck.
I gotta get it.
So if you're from the island, if you know what we know, you know what this is right here, baby. In Creole, they call it cun. In Jamaican, what they call it?
Can.
So, baby, we here, baby. Sugar cane.
Oh my god, yo.
Yeah.
Oh my god, yo.
Let me taste it. What is that? Let me taste it. Yeah.
Oh my. It's like, because you don't have to work for it.
Yeah.
You don't have
it's
to work
like
for it.
Of, it's just what out of it? The sugar cane. Oh, yeah, it's out of the cane, baby.
This nigga, I need that reaction.
It's out of the cane. You ain't got to work for it.
God,
I ain't got to cut it. I ain't got to suck. Nope. Straight in a cup?
Oh, my God.
Straight in a cup? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Mm.
Y que griten los que están presentes. Hoy va a bailar el presidente.
Where we at, G? Where we at?
Basically, we are in Rio Aral. Okay? Mm-hmm. As you can see, man, we're just amongst the locals, man, living life. I mean, everybody keeps asking the question, do you play basketball, do you play football? I say no. I'm an astronaut.
Yeah.
Estoy tan pegado que no salgo de tu mente. Quieren apagarme, yo no tengo.
So we're going scuba diving. Do you know how to swim?
We're going scuba diving, and I say my swimming level is about third grade level.
Pa bailar no existe pena. Este funky se candela. De aquí nadie va pa afuera. Esto lo bailan en la favela.
Gon' run it, count it, gon' show me something, eh, eh. Gon' talking that shit, keep on blocking, lil' bitch, busy trying to get lit, eh. Rose popping with the bomb and on me, and I keep on calling, and they know that I don't answer myself. No, I love you, mama, I got so much commas, girl, you know I'm only in lying to myself. So you flexing as a big lie. When I pull a get it, big lie. And you know that I'ma get mine. Yeah, yeah. Say you flexing as a big lie. When I pull a get it, big lie.
You see what I'll say? You want to say that?
So we just finished up scuba diving. That shit was clean.
Scuba diving, man. I didn't go, but it was like an absolute blast.
That shit was cool.
Next excursion, you know what I mean?
It's how my dog said, he gonna be out here. Motherfucker is exhausted.
Overall, like being here, like, I don't know, the we feel like we blend in more. Like, there's no kind of look of negativity. If you walk down the street, nobody's like these judges about what we look like. Sometimes in America, no matter where you walk, no matter where we walk, where we are.
Accepted for who we are. I haven't seen a color thing yet. And like, women will come up to us and praise us for being beautiful. These are compliments that we don't get from, you know, regular people in the States. So it's a little different. That's why, you know, people conceptualize Rio, because, you know, you feel like a celebrity because they actually understand and like see you for who you are, just a beautiful human being.
Rio has its own like racist history. I feel like it's more of a class thing here and not a race thing. No, it's a combination of the two. In America, we are seen as, our color is seen as a threat, but here, your color is seen as a sign of poverty. So you're not something to be afraid of. You're just a lower type of people. So in itself, we feel better because we're not a threat anymore, but we're still not treated equal though, you get what I'm saying? So it's a different dynamic. In America, we're black and poor. We're black, poor, and a threat. Here, we're just poor. You know?
So you're saying the darker we are, the poorer we look?
Why did you
see that? Are you saying this? Is that what you're saying?
Yeah. Brazil has a class system, most black people are poor. They try to disenfranchise them as much as possible, like in America. But in America, it's twice as bad because we're poor as well as a threat. And so we feel better just because we have one of those things off of us, of our back.
One layer off.
Yeah.
My fault, y'all. I'm a terrible fucking host. I have not shown y'all where the fuck we staying at yet. So listen, look at this. This the patio view. So right here we got a nice ass balcony. Look at that. Bomb, bomb, bomb. This the city of Rio. Like, you know what I'm saying? Like, this is what Rio looks like. This is what the fuck Rio looks like. See that right there? That's water. Agua. That's the water right there, motherfucker. So this is the living room. I'm saying that's the living room right here. And then we got this upstairs. Badal. We got a little, you know, chill, a little chill shit. If anybody wanna chill. We got the shower out. This is why I take a shower. Everybody like taking showers in their room. I come right here and take a shower because I'm like, yo, who else is taking a shower outside in Rio? We got the fucking beautiful ass mountains right there, downtown Rio. Look at that shit. And then this was gonna fuck y'all up. Look right here. That's the beach right there. Look at that water. That's the water right there. Back downstairs. This is the living room again. It's three floors. Tienes tres pisos. Tres pisos. So this room number one right here. This Casey room, look, bad out. You know, look at the views, check the views. This call room right here. Yo, what it look like, look at that. Everybody got their own bathroom. Everybody got it. Obrigado. Look at that, bad out. Get it open. It ain't, but you know, everybody got a little view though. This downtown Rio. Downtown Rio, obrigado. Whoop.
Welcome to MT GB Crib, it's your boy Jabba. I want to let you know the whole suite right here. Mm-hmm. That's my shit in the corner. Not reorganized right now, but that's cool. This is where the magic happens. Not too much magic, because I'm selfish and I gotta get mine by any means.
Oh shit. Alright. So we taking this fucking hike. Everybody in the gym. Everybody workout. But yo, this shit is fucking tough. My calves are on fire. Fucking fire.
Hiking up this motherfucking mountain.
Word.
Yeah, you already know, man. Hey, I'm just chilling.
We got the shades.
Exactly, man.
In attendance.
I can't be cool and hike at that.
Look. Oh. We started from way down there. That's where we started. Figure, choo-choo. Oh my God. Pull up. They can't even get his picture right. Okay, you got it. Yeah, get it. This is Brazil. Look at that. Beautiful.
My God! Oh my God!
Look, she different. Not a lot of people can say they did this. The Ciroc to the head in Brazil at the top of the highest mountain.
Ela fica maluca. Automaticamente. Doing something right, when you're doing something entrepreneurially, right? No, like, especially if somebody's never done exactly what you're trying to do, it is tough. You feel you can't get the answers. You can't. You, nobody can tell Nerd how to make it in the music industry like he wants to, because he has it in his head, or he knows what his brand wants to be. So you can give him feedback. You be like, hey Nerd, that picture you posted was ugly as fuck. But if he took criticism for everybody, he did what everybody told him, he'll never get anything done. You have people that are trying to please everybody. I can't please everyone. I only can please what I have going on personally. You know what I'm saying? So that's why somebody's thoughts and opinions, a lot of times opinions don't matter. Opinions are like assholes. Everyone has them and they all stink, right? Mm-hmm. So granted, if I'm y'all opinions are different from female. Hey, Trey, you need to focus up your pictures, bro. Focus on your pictures. Oh, okay, damn, you're right. My shit was kind of out of grain. That's different from, hey, Trey, you didn't get 1,000 likes on this picture. So have you had 1,000 likes on your picture before? You haven't, so you can't tell me how to get 1,000 likes. Maybe Nerd can say, hey, bro, this is how I, you know,
This is example, right?
Huh? Yeah, he can say. Oh. So what did he just say, right? He said how he does it, he does a self-analysis.
Yeah.
And he says, okay. He looks at the insights, okay, this is what type of picture, blah, blah, blah. He could tell me that, and that's factual because he actually did it. So I'm like, all right, well, let me try to do it this way because that was factual. You know what I'm saying? Instead of saying, oh, nigga, you ain't post this. And if you didn't get 1,000 likes on the picture, you can't tell me shit. If you didn't sell, if you're not a New York Times bestseller, honestly, you can't tell me anything. None of y'all. And vice versa, I can't tell you how to be in IT because I don't know. I did a self-analysis, right? I did a self-analysis. I said, okay. I don't post that much, right?
And then I
was like, damn, I don't post that much. And then I said, let me finish. And I said, okay, well, let me actually post more, granted. When you post more, if you follow the real social media influences, you follow like somebody like that DJ Khaled or P. Diddy, people that have actually done it, they post five times a day. So, granted, they're not, they, you, If P. Diddy only posted once a month, of course he'll probably get more likes. He's not gonna, he's not maximizing his likes. He's not looking for that. He's looking to be in people's.
He's maximizing
his engagement. He's looking, exactly. And he's looking to be in people's face.
Yep.
He's, it's subliminal marketing, period. Market. You look at Quavo, them, they'll post some bullshit. Misspelled words, everything. But what are they doing? They're being in people's face. They don't really do it for the likes because they know that, oh, somebody saw me again, a promoter might think of me and pay me $40,000 to come and see them because he just saw, because I just saw him again. He was on my mind. They stay on people's timeline. So granted, if I post a picture, okay, let me post more. If y'all have seen, within 2018, I've been doing a lot more posts. So now it's pretty, oh, then you only got 30 likes. Okay, but I've been engaging more. And I made, you know, I've been making more money from Die Cup Brothers over and the T from within the last year. From this time to January 1st, I made more money in the team within the last year altogether because
that's
I started putting out more, right? And why did I start putting out more? One, because I was a little bit more comfortable with my job. And then two, because I'm actually coming out with another book coming soon. So I'm just flooding the market and being on people's minds. Granted, I might not get 1,000 likes on a picture, but if I get 50 and I'm reminded that, nigga, I'm here. You know that. You know that. You know what I'm saying? So if you want to get an idea of my strategy, that's what I say. I don't do it for likes. I do it to be in people's face. Mm. Hey, Trey Bargain's here. Don't forget about me, nigga. That's what all the people, the influencers, yeah, the DJ Khaled, the P. Diddy's, the Quavos of the world, the any big celebrity like that, they always post often. They flood the market. And they have a strategy and it works, obviously. You know what I'm saying? Are they looking for likes? I don't think so. They're looking for motherfuckers to come book them for shows and shit. So if you want to get an idea of what my strategy is, that is it.
Thank you.
That makes sense.
Bye.
Yeah. Let's go.
My plan.
I'm gonna say to our brother,
this shit is delicious.
Eat my boxes.
He celebrated his birthday by himself, or he could celebrate it in Atlanta or whatnot, but he said, you know what? I wanna go out and say some seven kings, and I wanna live to the fullest in Rio de Janeiro, and he decided to. And I appreciate that too, because not only that, not only am I celebrating his birthday, but I'm celebrating, you know, my vacation and all other kings, you know, my brothers that I appreciate, that make me better as a person, that make me, that push me, that always critique me and make me a better individual, period, point blank. And iron sharpens iron, and we're here to celebrate life. Everybody, a lot of people die to have this. Nobody really appreciates what we really have. Yeah, something very, very great. And very powerful. So don't take it for granted. These your brothers. You know what I'm saying? I have a brother at home, but he's not here. You know what I'm saying? Y'all are brother, like my blood brothers. I appreciate that. So shout out to Abner. Abner. Shout out to y'all. Thank y'all for coming out.
Amen.
Let's drink up for that.
Y'all just trade with for this one.
Yeah.